So now, dear students, now we are taking question number 2. We have to check the injectivity and surjectivity of the given functions. So first function is what? F n to n means from the set of natural number to natural number. So when we talk about the set of natural number, we understand that natural numbers are from 1, 2, 3 and so on. And from n to n, so 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. Now you see, from this set to that set, domain is natural number and the codomain also is natural number. Then the function is given as f of x is equal to x square. Let me take f of x1 equal to f of x2. If I take this way, what I get here? F of x1 means x1 square is equal to x2 square. Now you see, square of a natural number, or you can say x1 square minus x2 square will be equal to 0. Or from here, what you can say? X1 plus x2 into x1 minus x2 is equal to 0. From here, what you can say? X1 is equal to minus x2 and plus x2. So that means x1 can be equal to minus x2 also, plus x2 also. Now, just you see, since the set is, the domain is natural numbers, domain is the set of natural number, that means that x1 and x2 both are natural number. That means there is no question of getting minus x2. So this will not be in our domain, because negative x2 means negative integer. So negative integer is not there. So that means x1 is equal to x2 only. X1 is equal to x2. So that means what you can say here, when we consider f of x1 equal to f of x2, we get that x1 equal to x2, because minus x2 cannot be an element of the domain set. No? So now from this discussion, what you can say? If we consider f of x1 is equal to f of x2, then we are arriving at the result x1 equal to x2. Did you understand? Means when images are equal, then the pre-images are also equal. It tells us that this function is one-one function. One-one function means one-to-one. One is connected to one, two is connected to four, no? By the function, because if you put here one in the function, f of one is equal to one square equal to one. Two, if you take here as input, then it will be f of two is equal to two square equal to four. Then three, if you take here, you'll get nine, like that, no? So this is one-one function. So since it is one-one function, we can say this function is injective. This function is injective. Now let us see, this function is if it is injective function, one-one function, then whether this function is onto or into function. Whether this function is onto or into function. To check it is onto or into, let us take this way, say y is equal to, suppose y is equal to, given here x square, y is equal to x square, then if y is equal to x square, then x will be equal to, from here what you can say, x will be equal to root y, no? That is, now think of one number y from this set of natural numbers, say 2 suppose. If I take here 2, what will get? X will be equal to, y is suppose 2, because 2 is there, so root 2, x will be equal to root 2, so x will be equal to root 2. Now you see, root 2 does not belong to this the domain. Root 2 is not there in the domain, because it is from natural number to natural number, so root 2 does not belong to, root 2 does not belong to n. So now you see, there are some elements, there are some elements in this codomain, there are some elements in codomain, means their pre-images are not there. There are some elements in codomain whose pre-images are not, because root 2 does not belong to the domain. But in the codomain 2 is there. So 2 is not an image of any element of this whole set, any element of the domain. So that means 2 is left out without having any pre-image. 2 is left out. So what you can say now? What you can say? This function is not onto, because there will be so many such elements whose pre-images are not there. 2, its image is not there. Like 3, its image pre-image is not there. 3 is not an image of any element. 2 is not an image of any element. So by the same function. So now what you can say? That is this function is f is into. This is our conclusion. So whether the given function is onto or into, you can check that way. Whenever you want to check this function is onto or into, just you take the function and express the x in terms of y. That is one trick. It means what it was given, y is equal to x square, means f of x means y, no? Y is equal to x square. So your work will be to express the x in terms of y. So x is equal to root over y. Because x square equal to y means x is equal to root over y. Then think of one y from the codomain. Y, the one value for y. So I can take say 2, because all these are values of y only, 2. If I take here 2, x becomes root 2, and root 2 does not belong to this n, the set of natural number. That means it is not in domain. So that means so many elements in codomain have no pre-images in domain. Therefore, the function is not onto, because so many elements are left out without having pre-image. Have you understood? So then we can say the function f is on into function only. It is not onto. So what you got? This given function is, first of all, it is 1, 1, but it is not onto, it is into. It is into function. Now, see the second question. Second question is what? It is about, it is a function from z to z, no? It is a function from z to z, means from the set of integers from two integers. So when we talk about integers are 0, plus minus 1, plus minus 2, plus minus 3, all these are integers. That is, the domain is having elements minus 1, 1, 0, 2, minus 2, and so on. And the codomain also have the same elements. Now, if we apply this rule, f of x equal to x square, now I think, if I take here, say I take a minus 1. Minus 1, its image will be? Minus 1, its image will be plus 1. No, minus 1 is linked to plus 1. Again, if I take 1, then also it will be plus 1 only, because 1 square. Minus 1 square is plus 1 square, plus 1. So, plus 1 also will give us plus 1 only. So, that means it is a function, many one function, means many elements have got the same image. Like 2 will be connected to 4, again minus 2 also will give us 4. So, this is a many one function. About it is onto or into. So, this function we have understood, this is a many one function. F of minus 1 is 1, f of 1 is also 1. So this is a many one function. But you see, here are so many elements, like say minus 1, minus 2. These elements are there, whose pre-images are not there. Minus 1 is not linked to any element of that domain. Just you see, minus 1, it cannot be the element addition. Because you see, what is our function? That y is equal to x square. Y is equal to x square. And x square is always a positive number. Think about x square. X square is always positive. Always positive. X square will give us always positive. Always positive. If x square is always positive, then whatever, because x square will be from here only. X square will be from here, from the codomain. So then, if x square is greater than or equal to 0, if x square is greater than or equal to 0, then that means we have to exclude these elements whose pre-images will not find, like elements like minus 2, minus 1, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, all these elements will not have any pre-images, because x square cannot represent them. X square is representing only positive elements. So that means in this codomain, there will be so many elements left out whose pre-images will not be able to see here, will not be able to find in the domain. So that is, you can write like this. Since x square is greater than or equal to 0, therefore f is into, because f is into function, because there are so many elements left out in the codomain whose pre-images are not found. It is not a onto function. Now come to third question. It is given from R to R, means real number. Real number, when you say, we understand it is from minus infinity to plus infinity. No, minus infinity to plus infinity. So when you talk about this function f r to r, we understand from here that this time, suppose I consider f of x1, no, I want to check it is 1, 1 or not, or many 1, it is what? Suppose f of x1, we suppose that f of x1 and f of x2 are equal. Suppose these two images are equal. F of x1 is an image and f of x2 also is an image. Both images are equal, suppose. So here x1, x2 are there, and there f of x1 and f of x2, both are suppose equal. F of x2, both are suppose equal. Now, if f of x1 and f of x2 are equal, then f of x1, how will you write? X1 square, no? F of x1 will be equal to written as x1 square. And f of x2 will be written as x2 square. Then transpose x2 square in this side. X1 square minus x2 square will give us 0. From this what you can say? X1 plus x2 into x1 minus x2 is equal to 0. From this what you can say? That x1 is equal to minus x2 or x2 or minus x2. X2 or minus x2. X1 can be equal to x1, x2 or minus x2. So now you see, x1 is equal to, that means x2 and minus x2, since it is a set of real number, it is a set of real number, domain is real and codomain also is real, real to real. So in that domain, suppose two elements are there, x2 and this one, x2 and minus x2. Then if x1 is equal to x2 and minus x2, both their images can be same. Both their images can be same, f of x1 and f of x2 are same only. So if f of x1 equal to f of x2 and x1 is equal to x2 also and minus x2 also, that means two different elements. Try to understand from here, two different elements, x2 and x, minus x2, both are different. Two different elements, their images can be equal. Because if I take here, in place of x1, I take minus x2, then also not wrong, because what was my starting? F of x1 equal to f of x2. So f of x1, no, equal to f of x2, I am saying. But x1 is same as x2, minus x2 also. Suppose I write here, minus x2. There is no problem. So f of minus x2 and f of plus x2, both are same, that means. And if two different elements give same images, then we say it is a many one function. So this function is many one. F is many one. Because many elements are connected to the same element. So this is a many one function. Now you see, it is a many one function, you understood. Now what type of elements, what type of elements will be there in the codomain? X square means x square stand for what? Again, once again, x square stand for what? All the time positive values. All the time positive values. X square is always greater than or equal to 0. Because our function is what? F of x equal to x square. Means you'll square x, then only you'll get the image. So x will be from domain. And x square means it is in the codomain. So x square is a positive number. But in our codomain, all positive, negative, all the numbers are there. Because it is the set of real numbers. The codomain is the set of real numbers. So their negative numbers also are there. Then minus 2 belongs to R. Means in the codomain it is there. But minus 2 cannot be the image of any element of the domain. Because minus 2 is not a minus 2 cannot be represented by x square. X square can never be equal to minus 2. Did you understand, students? Because image is formed by what? Squaring x. So x square equal to minus cannot be equal to minus 2. Students, did you understand what I have said? X square cannot be equal to minus 2. The reason is that minus 2 is a real number, though it is, but we are taking images by squaring x. So when will you get, if you square any real number, when will you get minus 2? Will you get minus 2? You'll never get by squaring any real number. So that means minus 2 is here in the codomain, but it is not image of any element. Minus 2 is there in the codomain, but it is not image of any element. When some elements are left out in the codomain without having any pre-image, no, then that type of function, what we say? It is a into function. So this function f is many one into. Many one into. Many one and into. Many one into function, this one. Thank you. Now, Let us see question number 4, Roman number 4. It is a function from n to n, natural number to natural number. So see thing, students, this is a set of natural number, and this also 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. It is there, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on, dot, dot, dot. So n to n. Now, let us consider two elements, x1 and x2, which belongs to the domain, x1 and x2, and their images suppose equal. F of x1 equal to suppose f of x2. F of x1 is equal to suppose f of x2. Then f of x1, how will you write f of x1? x1 cube. And f of x2 is x2 cube. So x1 cube minus x2 cube. x1 cube minus x2 cube. x2 cube will be equal to 0. And if we factorize it, what shall we get? X1 cube, x1 minus x2 into x1 square plus x2 square minus x1 x2 is equal to 0. So that means it will give us x1 is equal to x2, and from this x1 square plus x2 square plus minus plus x1 x2 is equal to 0. Now see, if I want to find out the roots of this, from this we got x1 equal to x2. Now from this, can we find out any root? Actually, this will not give you any root, because suppose you divide this whole thing by x2 square, what will happen? It will become x1 by x2 the whole square, plus x2 square will give us 1 here. x2 square, when we will divide here, it will be x1 by x2 is equal to 0. No? And this x1 by x2, suppose I take it as t. So it will be t square plus 1 plus this will be t is equal to 0. Supposing this t as t to represent x1 by x2. x1 by x2. So what I got? T square plus t plus 1 is equal to 0. And this is a quadratic equation where discriminant is less than equal to 0. When discriminant is less than 0, that type of quadratic equation has no root. So it does not have any root. Ultimately, it does not have any root. No root you will get. No real root you will get. So there is no question of taking this. No, this part we don't require to consider at all. Just you consider addition x1 equal to x2. So that means what you got here? When f of x1 and f of x2, you take two images as equal images, then your outcome is what? x1 equal to x2. It says what? When images are equal, then pre-images are also equal. It says that the function is 1, 1. That means 1, its cube is 1. 2, its cube is 8. 3, its cube is 27. 4, its cube is 64. So this is a 1, 1 function. So it says that f is 1, 1. 1, 1 function. Now, whether this function is onto or into. Just you think about 2 in the codomain. 2 belongs to the codomain N. 2 belongs to the codomain N. So, can there be an element in domain whose, say, x cube will give us 2? X cube will give us, suppose, 2. Then what I get x is equal to 2 to the power of 1 by 3. 2 to the power of 1 by 3, cube root of 2. But cube root of 2, this 2 to the power of 1 by 3 does not belong to the domain N, natural number. It is not a natural number. So then what happens? That means for this 2, there is no pre-image. For this 2, there is no pre-image. That means this function is not onto function, it is into function. That is, f is into. So this function is into function, because there are so many elements in the codomain whose pre-images are not there in the domain. Because that is the reason when to say into and when to say onto. So there are so many elements, like 2, it is not the image. Then 3, it is not the image of any element. So like that, there are so many elements whose pre-images are not there. Thank you, students. Now let us take the fifth question. It is from z to z. Z to z means integer to integers. Integers, when you say, then we understand plus 1, minus 1, 0, then 2, minus 2, huh? 2 minus 2, 3, minus 3, all these elements are there in Z. Again, the same way in this also, 1, minus 1, 0, 2, minus 2, huh? 3, minus 3. So now you see, this function is given as f of x equal to x cube. So that means, from this Z to Z, that means if you take cube, the elements of domain say 1 cube is 1, then minus 1 cube is, minus 1 cube is minus 1, 0 cube is 0, 2 cube is 8, so here will be 8, minus 2 cube is minus 8. So then what do you get here? What you get? That means it is a 1-1 function. Every element has got, the domains, every element has got distinct image in the codomain. So it is a 1-1 function. Since x1, f of x1, if f of x1 equal to f of x2, no, we get x1 equal to x2. Therefore, f is 1-1. Now think about whether it is onto or not, or it is into. See, let us take one element, say 2 belongs to Z, and I am taking y is equal to 2, suppose. If I take y is equal to 2, y is actually obtained by cubing x, so x cube is equal to 2. That means x should be equal to what? 2 raised to the power of 1 by 3, which is not an integer, because 2 to the power of 1 by 3 is not an integer. That is, 2 to the power of 1 by 3 does not belong to the domain. When the element does not belong to the domain, that means this 2 is not an image of any element of the domain. So then what we can say, this function is into function, because there are so many elements in the codomain whose pre-images are not there. So therefore f is into, hence solve this question. So students, just we have discussed this whole question just to make you realize how to check when function is injective, surjective, or it is bijective, onto, into, how to check it, that we are solving this whole question, so that so many questions related to this question can be solved by learning this question. Thank you.